Advances in the forensic analysis of body fluids found at crime scenes are helping to identify those guilty of a crime, as well as preventing miscarriages of justice. Dr. Graham Williams's latest research at the University of Huddersfield has solved one of the few limitations of DNA profiling, distinguishing between the DNA of identical twins.
DNA profiling has been a fantastic technique for the criminal investigation. If you get a DNA profile from a crime scene stain and a DNA profile from an individual, we can say whether that individual could have contributed to that crime scene. The strength of the evidence between two unrelated people is said to be 1 in a billion, and the set of false siblings might have a match probability of 1 in 10,000. However, if you're part of an identical twin, you'd have the same DNA profile, and therefore the chance of matching DNA profile would be 1 in 1. The problem that leads, if you have a crime being committed, you get a DNA profile and it matches against a suspect, and that suspect had an identical twin, we cannot tell the difference between whether it was a suspect or his brother or sister. Now, obviously, you can't lock up both people. You have to pick one or the other, and we've not been able to do that. So what my research has done is look into ways of being able to differentiate between identical or monozygotic twins. And one area where we've done this is something called epigenetics. And what epigenetics is the factors that influence whether a gene is expressed or not. Say, for example, you have blue eyes. You would have the gene for blue eyes in your DNA, but that gene would be turned on. That gene could also be present in other people, but turned off. If, for example, you have a blood-specific marker, you would need a blood-specific gene. So your exposure to a certain environment can affect whether your gene is turned on or off. So the gene turned on, you express a certain protein, and that changes something in your appearance. And if you have a set of identical twins who live in a different environment, let's say, for example, one takes up smoking, but the other one doesn't, that their epigenome will be different. The more they're exposed to a different environment, the more different their epigenome is. And so what we do, we characterise certain parts of the epigenome, and providing that the twin epigenome is sufficiently different, we are able to differentiate between them. All we have to do is extract their DNA, identify a marker, and then we can test them to see whether the marker is different or not.
You can find out more about research at the University of Huddersfield with our research news, the online Discover magazine, or follow us on Twitter at Wheel of Research.
The University of Huddersfield, inspiring tomorrow's professionals.